Welcome to the session on modulus counter. At the end of this session, students will be able to design a synchronous mod counter. Let us see what is mod counter. Modulus counter are defined based on the number of states that the counter will sequence through before returning back to its original value. For example, 2-bit counter that counts from 00 to 11 in binary, that is 0 to 3 in decimal, has a modulus value of 4. Hence, here the states are 00, 01, 1011 and written back to 00. Note that it has taken 4 clock pulses to get from 00 to 11. As in this simple example, there are only 2 bits, then the maximum number of possible output states for the counter is 2 to the power 2. Therefore, a mod n counter will require n number of flip-flops connected together to count single data bit while providing 2 to the power n different output states. And n is always a whole integer value. Here we can visually see the operation of this 2-bit asynchronous counter using a truth table. We can see from the truth table of the counter of Q1 and Q2. When Q1 equals to 0 and Q2 equals to 0, the count is 00. After applying the clock pulse, the value becomes Qn1 and Q2 is 0, giving the count value 01. And after the next clock pulse, the value becomes 10. And finally, the value becomes Q1, Q2 equals to 11, giving a count of 11. The application of the next clock pulse causes the count to return back to 00. Therefore, it counts continuously up in a binary sequence of 00, 01, 10, 11 and next 00. Here, if a single flip-flop on its own could be thought of as a mod 2 counter, as it has single output resulting in a count of 2, either 0 or 1. But a single flip-flop on its own produces a limited counting sequence. So, by connecting together more flip-flops to form a chain, and we can increase the counting capacity and construct a mod counter of any value. If a single flip-flop can be considered as a mod 2, then adding a second flip-flop would give us a mod 4 counter, allowing it to count in 4 discrete steps. Then we have seen that a mod 2 counter consists of single flip-flop and a mod 4 counter requires 2 flip-flop, allowing it to count in 4 discrete steps. Here the Q1, Q2 and clock in timing diagram are shown to be simultaneous even though it is connecting, or the connection represents an asynchronous counter. The output Q1 is least significant flip-flop changes for every clock pulses, and the output of Q2 makes transition whenever Q1 changes from 1 to 0. Here a question: how many natural states will there be in a 4-bit ripple counter? Your options are 4, 8, 16, 32. Take a pause of this video and write your answer. Your answer is C. In an n-bit counter, the total number of states are 2 to the power n. Therefore, in a 4-bit counter, the total number of states are 2 to the power 4 is nothing but 16 states. A synchronous mod 6 counter. Suppose we want to design a mod 6 counter. How could we do that? First, we know that m equals to 6, that is mod number equals to 6. So 2 to the power n must be greater than 6, as 2 to the power 1 equals to 2, 2 to the power equals to 2 equals to 4, and 2 to the power 3 equals to 8, and 8 is greater than our 6. Then we need a counter with 3 flip-flops, giving us a natural count of 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1 in a binary. Then we can use a combinational logic circuit around a basic counter, either synchronous or asynchronous, to produce any type of mod counter we require, as each of the counter unique output states can be coded to reset the counter at the desired count. The truth table is, as we are constructing a mod 6 counter, we want the counter to reset back to the 0 after a count of decimal number 5. However, we can see from the attached truth table here that the count of 6 gives us the output condition q1 equals to 0, q2 equals to 1, and q3 equals to 1. Here in this diagram, here we use two input NAND gate to code the 110 state, but the first time that q2 and q3 are both at logic 1, as when the count reaches 6. So a two input NAND gate connected to q2 and q3 could be used, and we can code these output states of 110 to give us a single signal to clear the counter back to 0 with the help of two input NAND gate. In binary code, the output sequence count will look like 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101. But when it reaches the state of 110, the combinational logic circuit will detect this 110 state and produce an output at logic level 0, and we can then use the resulting low output from the NAND gate to reset the counter back to 0 after its output of 0 to 5 decimal count, and giving us the required mod 6 counter. When the output from the combinational circuit is low, it has no effect on the counting sequence. Here the q1, q2, q3 and clock in timing diagram are shown. The output q1 is least significant flip-flop changes for every clock pulses, and the output of q2 makes transition whenever q1 changes from 1 to 0. Similarly, q3 makes transition whenever q2 changes from 1 to 0, and this can be achieved by connecting q to the clock input of the MSB bit. Here, asynchronous mod 10 counter. If we take the modulo 16 asynchronous counter and modified with the additional logic gates, it can be made to give a decayed counter. For use in standard decimal counting and arithmetic circuits, such counters are generally referred to as decayed counter. A decayed counter requires resetting to 0 when the output count reaches to the decimal value of 10, that is 1010. The decayed counter has 4 output producing a 4-bit binary number, and by using external NAND gate, we can detect the occurrences of the 9th counting state, and after that it reset the counter back to 0, as with other mod counter, it receives the input clock pulse one by one and it counts up from 0 to 9 repeatedly. Once it reaches the counter 9, the counter goes back to 0000 instead of counting 1010. The basic circuit of decade counter can be made from GK flip-flop that switches state on the negative trailing edge of the clock signal. Here, the output Q1 is least significant flip-flop changes for every clock pulses, and the output Q2 makes transition whenever Q2 changes from 1 to 0. Similarly, Q3 makes transition whenever Q2 changes from 1 to 0, and Q4 makes transition whenever Q3 changes from 1 to 0, and this can be achieved by connecting Q to the clock input of the MSB bit. So, modulus counter are defined based on the number of states that the counter will sequence through before returning back to its original value. In general, an n-bit asynchronous counter is called mod n counter, where mod number equals to 2 to the power n. In this case of modulo m counter, they do not count to all the possible states. M is the number smaller than 2 to the power n. These are my references. Thank you.